several of my readers have said that reading my books is kind of like sitting around listening to me tell a story, so I thought I'd try it on video. This tale is about a couple of events on the Luboff tour that somehow managed to elude my memory while I was writing Three Stages. I think it was Chattanooga, Tennessee, our first gig below the Mason-Dixon line, when our final encore, there were always at least two, was Norman's lush, modernistic version of Dixie, the song that you're hearing now. Anyhow, as soon as they recognized the song, the entire audience stood. We, the whole choir, almost broke up. It was like we were singing the national anthem. This was repeated without exception in all the gigs we did in the South. But the kicker came a few nights later. We'd had a fairly short trip that day and weren't really worn out after the show, and we had a fairly short trip the next day, so we had a little beer-soaked penny ante poker game, me and Norman and a couple of the other guys, and the TV set was on, and in those days, local TV stations went off the air at midnight or 1 a.m., and so midnight rolled around, somebody bet 3 cents, and the station started to go off the air. On the screen was the Capitol building of whatever state we were in, flying the Confederate flag, and as the camera began to zoom in, what did we hear? Not the USA national anthem, but, you guessed it, that very same recording of Dixie. That's when Norman, the dyed-in-the-wool Yankee liberal, told us all that he had written the arrangement as a joke